everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This is the third day of our visit to Istanbul. In the morning, we went to buyukada island, and now we have returned to Emi-no-nu. We are at Sirkeci stop. To go to Grand Bazar, we are taking a tram. One of the best things about Istanbul is that it has a very good mass transit system. Trams and metro trains are neat and clean and very economical. It costs only 3.5 lira for a person for an entire route. Before Corona pandemic, Grand Bazar was one of the most visited bazaar in the world. It is also one of the biggest covered bazaar in the world. We have left the tram at Beyazit-Kapalıçarşı stop. Now we are walking toward the entrance of Grand Bazar. This is nuruosmaniya gate. Let's go inside. In Turkish language, Grand Bazar is called Kapalıçarşı, meaning the covered market or closed market. For being grand in size, it is also called Büyükçarşı. Grand Bazar has 61 covered streets and over 4,000 shops. Total covered area of Kapalıçarşı is about 30,700 square meters. It is situated between two famous mosques, Beyazit and nuruosmaniya. Construction of Grand Bazar was started right after conquest of Constantinople in 1455. Sultan Muhammad II started two bazaars for trading of textiles and jewels near his palace. Jewels Bazaar was called Johar-e-Bazistan and Textile Bazaar was called Bazistan-e-Jadid. After the completion of Grand Bazar, the building was endowed to Waqf of Hagia Sophia Mosque. Within every passing year, new traders kept on establishing their businesses in the Grand Bazar. After expansion of Ottoman Empire to almost three continents, bazaars and surrounding khans or caravanserais became hub of Mediterranean trade. Till first half of 19th century, there were 67 roads, 5 mosques, 7 fountains and 8 gates which are opened each day in the morning and closed in the evening. Maybe this was the reason for naming it as Kapalıçarşı or closed market. In the beginning, each merchant was allotted with a small portion of bazaar to establish his shop, which was called dolap. Since its establishment, the bazaar witnessed many calamities. The fire of 1701 nearly burnt the bazaar to ashes. To resuscitate the previous glory, Grand Vizier Nusayr Ali Damat Ibrahim Pasha rebuilt several parts of the complex in 1730. This is a ceramic light shop. You can find a lot of such outlets here. This is another view of light shops. Beautiful and colorful lights are one of the prominent features of home decor in Turkey. Carpets have a very special place in Turkish tradition. You can find many Turkish carpet shops in the bazaar. The most common carpets today are manufactured on a small scale in Konya and Ankara area. These are called Cerivan, Kesari, Mekri, Ereki, Gördish, Kula Oshek, Yayali and Yegrebedir carpets. Much of the architecture of the old building is still intact, and you can see the original colors on centuries-old arches. Thank you. You can buy garments at reasonable price here, but you can only see local brands here. Kava is one of the most favorite drink in Turkey. Kava shops are common sights in Istanbul. Here is a camera-loving Turk. The Grand Bazar complex is huge. It is not possible to visit every corner of it in one day. That finished today's visit. This is nuruosmaniya mosque and its surrounding area. You can see more shops outside the Grand Bazar. Prices here are relatively low as compared to the prices of same communities inside the bazaar. Third day of our visit to Istanbul has come to an end. Very tired but happy, we are going back to our hotel. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for future videos.